the Babe, the world's Redeemer, first revealed his sacred face, evermore and evermore. O'er ye heights of heaven adore him, angel hosts his praises sing. Our dominions bow before him, and extol our God and King. Let no tongue on earth be silent, every voice in concert sing. Evermore and Christ to thee with God the Father, and the Holy Ghost to thee. Hear that chant with my thanksgiving, and unwearied praises be. Honor, glory, and
welcome to our concert tonight. We're glad you're here. We're glad to be here, and we hope we have a good time. That song, Of the Father's Love Begotten, has a history spanning over 1,500 years. A Roman poet wrote the words in 348 AD, and later the poem was matched to a plain chant melody in the 10th century. That's 700 years between right there. And our English translation was finally written a mere 150 years ago. On the back of your program, there is an image of the melody as it was published in 1582. This song has been around a long time. We want to give you some information about the songs we're going to sing, and it saves time to describe more than one song at a time. But please feel free to applaud after each song if you wish. Our next song has a history also. Greensleeves was a song published in London in 1580. It's about a scorned woman dressed in green, and it was very popular. In a Shakespeare play, Falstaff exclaims, "Let the sky thunder to the tune of Greensleeves." So in 1602, it was a popular song. It still is today sung. And now fast forward to Victorian England in the 19th century, and for 200 previous years to that, Puritan groups believed that celebrating a Christmas holiday was a bad thing. So there was a nostalgia in the 19th century for Christmas traditions that had been suppressed. And in the 1800s, things began to change. Christmas carols were republished. Prince Albert introduced the first Christmas tree, and the first Christmas card was created in 1843. One of the greatest influences on re-promoting the Christmas holiday was Charles Dickens' novel, A Christmas Carol, which was also published in 1843. In the midst of all these changes, William Dix wrote a verse called, "What Child Is This?" And it goes with the Greensleeves melody. And so we're going to sing that song tonight as "What Child Is This?" After that, we're going to sing Break Forth, O Beauteous Heavenly Light, one of two songs by Johann Sebastian Bach that we'll sing tonight. Both of them are actually appropriated melodies and words created by German composers 100 years before Bach. The first one was in the Christmas Oratorio of 1734, and this particular song was harmonized and arranged by him. All the contributors have their names on the music, but Bach gets all the credit. Here is "What Child Is Us," "What Child Is This," and then the Bach. The legend of Good King Wenceslas is based on the life of a historical Wenceslas I, Duke of Bohemia, who lived from 907 to 935 until he was murdered by his brother at the age of 28. He was considered a martyr and a saint immediately after his death, and was the model for the Middle Ages concept of a righteous king. They compared good kings to Wenceslas I. We know the poem was at Christmas time because Wenceslas looked out on the Feast of Stephen, and the Feast of Stephen is the second day of Christmas. I didn't know that. The poem was written in 1873 and was set to the tune of a 13th century song. The modern city of Prague in the Czech Republic gives prominence to St. Wenceslas. The main square in the city is called Wenceslas Square, and in his honor, high up on the above the square is the statue of him, great big statue of him on his great big horse. Another statue of him is inside of St. Vitus Cathedral, which is nearby, which he founded in 928, the largest and most important church in Prague. So St. Wenceslas was the real deal. After that, Jesu Bambino was written by Pietro Alessandro Jan. That has a nice ring. He was born in Italy, and for a time he was organist at the Vatican in Rome. And he came to the United States at age of 21 in 1907, and later became the organist at St. Patrick's Cathedral, which he held until his death in 1943. He composed a lot of works for organ, piano, orchestra, and voice. Jesu Bambino is often referred to as Pietro Jan's Christmas song. The prominent solo in this piece is going to be sung by our resident chaplain, Ralph Keither. But first, Good King Wenceslas.
Bring me wine, bring me pine loves here. again the heart with rapture glows to greet the holy night that gave the world its Christmas rose, its King of love and light.
Let every voice acclaim his name, the grateful chorus swell, the grateful chorus swell, from paradise to earth he came, that we with him might grow, that we with him might grow. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him.
This Mike and Eve have been fighting all week. We're going to enjoy a flute solo by soon-to-be resident Fran Creasy, accompanied by Leslie Bush. Thank you. Children, Go Where I Send Thee is an African-American spiritual around 200 years old. We're not quite sure. It's a counting lesson and a Bible lesson rolled into one, and as you'll see, it's also a Christmas song. The lyrics count up to 10, and each number refers to a biblical event. Many of the number references will be obvious to you, but some of them are less obvious, so I'll tell you about those. 3 was the Hebrew children, refers to Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. 4 was the 4 came knocking at the door, refers to the 4 men who tried to carry the paralytic through the door and could not, so they went up on the roof and lowered him through the roof. Then 8 was the 8 who stood at the gate, refers to Noah, his wife, 3 sons, and 3 daughters-in-law who were promised entry into heaven. And 9 was the 9 that got left behind, refers to the 9 lepers out of 10 that Jesus healed and didn't come back to thank him. The next song is Masters in This Hall. It combines a French opera tune with words from a Christmas carol written by an Englishman. And Fred Waring's stalwart arrangers, Harry Simeoni and Holly Yates, polished it up and made it feel like a carol from the 1500s. First, Children, Go Where I Send Thee.
I'm gonna
and the 8x8 goes 8 for the 8 that stood after 8, and 7 for the 7 that went up to heaven, and 6 for the jars where the wine was fixed, and 5 was the gospel preachers, and 4 was the poor came knocking at the door, and 3 was the Hebrew children, and 2 was the Paul and Silas, and 1 was the itty bitty baby born in Bethlehem. Children, go where I send thee. How shall I send thee? I'm gonna send thee 9x9, cause 9 for the 9 that were left behind, and 8 for the 8 that stood at the gate, and 7 for the 7 that went up to heaven, and 6 for the stars where the wine was fixed, and 5 was the gospel preachers, and 4 was the poor came knocking at the door, and 3 was the Hebrew children, and 2 was the Paul and Silas, and 1 was the itty bitty baby born in Bethlehem. Children, go where I send thee. How shall I send thee? I'm gonna send thee 10x10, what's 10 for the 10 commandments, and 9 for the 9 that are left behind, and 8 for the 8 that stood at the gate, and 7 for the 7 that went up to heaven, and 6 for the jars where the wine was fixed, and 5 was the gospel preachers, and 4 was the poor came knocking at the door, and 3 was the Hebrew children, and 2 was the Paul and Silas, and 1 was the itty bitty baby born in Bethlehem.
There's a song in the air, first appeared as a poem in a Sunday school collection about 1874, and 25 years later, a church musician wrote the tune that we know now for the poem. This lovely carol is now a century old, and at one time it was quite popular. Today it isn't on the church Christmas song hit parade, though. Maybe we can start a movement tonight. And then, our next piece is one of Johann Sebastian Bach's most popular choral works. It's the 10th and final movement of his cantata number 147. That cantata is a work for a complete worship service, but we're only going to sing the last section. What we now call Jesu, Joy of Man's Desiring, has been taken up by countless groups in many languages, many instrumental settings and accompaniments. And the accompaniment itself to the central melody, which is played for us by Leslie Bush, is more familiar than the song itself and perhaps more admired.
There's a song in the air.
it's your turn. We're going to sing some hymns, some carols. And you should have a song sheet in your program with the words. Could we have a few lights to make the words legible? Very good. There it is, right down there. Right. Okay, the first one is Joy to the World. We'll sing all three verses. That's a short song. And put the wrong title in the next song. So it's really, O Come All Ye Faithful, and we're going... So and we're going to sing all three verses of that. O come...
The audience? Would they like to? Would you like to stand up and sing?
Yeah.
Okay. Those who are able.
Thank you.
without singing Silent Night. So that's what we're going to do now.
Dim the lights so we're on the stars on the stage now. Thank you. Maggie, are you here? Maggie Daugherty? Yes, she is. Maggie Daugherty has created more than 50 delightful alternative lyrics for these concerts beginning in 1997. This year, we decided to revive her 2004 parody of Walking in a Winter Wonderland, which became Here in Tryon's Winter Wonderland. The words are printed on the back of your carolyn sort there. And after that, we're going to sing Santa Claus is Coming to Town. It was written in 1934 when I was 5 years old, and I really like it, and so we're going to sing it.
Thank you.
and marvel at our tree here. Richly clothed in brilliant Christmas hue, makes you feel the spirit just to be here. On every heart the spirit is renewed. On each heart flocks are blowing, gathered friends all are going. We're glad to be here for our Christmas cheer. Here in Zion's Christmas wonderland, music fills the air with Christmas carols. Voices sweet the ancient story tell. Everyone is dressed in gay apparel. Our hearts rejoice within the season smell. There are wreaths on each door here, holly decked.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
Next, we're going on a musical Globe Trekkers Christmas world tour. We're going to visit Ireland, Latin America, and Christmas Island. We all know where Ireland and Latin America are, but what about Christmas Island? There are two geographical Christmas islands in the world. Both are tropical islands discovered for us by British seamen in the same sense that Columbus discovered America. The islands were actually populated centuries before the Europeans arrived. Keep in mind also that Lyle Moraine, who wrote this song, Christmas Island, in 1946, the year after World War II ended. What Christmas Island did he have in mind? On December 25th, 1643, an English merchant ship discovered an island in the Indian Ocean and named it Christmas Island. It's about 200 miles south of modern Jakarta, Indonesia, and 1,000 miles northwest of Australia. It's a long way away. It has a lot of unique wildlife, and a resort has been developed in the last few years, but it was not a destination in 1946. So that Indian Ocean Christmas Island is not the one. 133 years later, on December 24th, 1777, Captain James Cook of the Royal Navy discovered an island in the Pacific Ocean, and he named it Christmas Island. It's a part of an archipelago that's now called the Line Islands. And Christmas Island is about 1,100 miles south of Hawaii and 500 miles north of Tahiti. Unfortunately, it's not a suitable island for a resort, but it was in the news in World War II when Lyle Moraine wrote his song, and we assume he conjured up a nice tropical paradise on that Pacific Ocean Christmas Island. But it wouldn't have worked. But so what? Dozens of recordings have been made, starting with the Andrews Sisters in 1946, even Walt Disney's Ariel, and more recently Jimmy Buffett, all kind of recordings, and we're going to book our musical holiday on the composer's make-believe Christmas Island. So get your passports. Here we go, Killarney in Ireland, Latin America, and the Christmas Islands, all accompanied with flute music by Fran Creasy and bongo and steel drums by Gene Howe. Well, you've been a grand audience, and we thank you for coming, and we're going to send you off with a medley of two Christmas carols, Christmas favorites, excuse me, I'm sure you're going to know. And afterwards, please join us in the lobby for punch and cookies. Oh, please, yes.
We wrote it on another piece of paper. I wanted to take this time on behalf of the whole chorus that has contributed. We want to say some special thank yous to Ann Morgan for her contribution in the early part. We won't try and distribute all of these. Fran Creasy, next time you'll be in regular. That'd be good. That'll be good.
About 1 month.
1 month, okay. Right. And Jean Howell, let's see, which hat was she wearing today? I think she shed a couple, but she's got more. And we wanted to thank Leslie Bush, too. Yeah. But the big one goes to the big guy up front, who's been working for months and months and months and months and months, patiently, Jim McAllister.
Christmas made you feel.
Lord.